Yeah, we met him on 15th July.
Okay.
In JJ Hospital, when we came to know that he was shifted there, we took the permission from the Taloja jail and then went and met him in JJ Hospital on 15th July. He
okay.
was in Ward 11, which is a transit ward they call us. That is before the COVID test. They keep him. They keep them patients there.
Okay.
There we went and we went to meet him and we saw him and we met him there. When we reached there, what we could see, it was ward number 11, it's called as, what we could see there is, he was sitting in a corner of a bed. This bed was covered with, that is, four sides covered bed. That is, patients did not fall down, such a kind of bed that it was.
Okay.
And he was sitting in a corner, leaning to the rods, the bed barrier, barricade kind of a thing. So he was just leaning and sitting there with the complete folded legs and everything. And there was a nurse and there was also a police constable there. When we went and when the first thing they asked was, are you his family kind of a thing? When we were trying to say that we have permission and all that. Then the first thing nurse said is, move him inside. He may fall, move him inside. So when we tried to move and take care of him, what we realized is the bed sheet was wet. The bed sheet was completely wet there. So he was searching for a dry place. So he moved himself to one of the corners of the bed. And he was sitting there, maybe asking what he needs there. So they were not even touching. The nurse or constable were not touching him or not trying to move him, just telling him to move, which he is unable to do, maybe trying to explain. So we moved him and we asked the bed sheet to be changed. So then they gave a sheet to us, this hospital kind of fiber sheet kind of a thing, mask which is used, that kind of a material, paper kind of a thing. We ourselves changed it. They gave it to us. We ourselves changed it. This was the physical condition there. And also, there was no, we did not see, we didn't see any equipment. There is not even, there was no drip. His main issue was sodium. There is lots of sodium, which we have been talking for some time. But there was no drip or any oximeter or any kind of apparatus there. And also he was suffering with BPH. BPH is a prostate gland enlargement issue, which will have, the urination cannot be controlled. So there was no catheter, urine catheter, or any bag or any such kind of a thing. And he was brought there on 13th evening, and we met him on 13th afternoon he was brought there, and 15th, 3 o'clock we met, so it's 3 days. In the 3 days, I don't know what treatment was happening there. Maybe any medication was added, I don't know about that. But he was just lying on the bed, that is, he was just there on the bed. We couldn't see any kind of equipment or anything there. So this was our last meeting. 16th, again, we went there to see him and talk to him. But by the time we reached to the ward, doctors told us that he was already tested positive. So we cannot see him there. We cannot meet him there. As we have gone from Hyderabad, we requested them at least we'll see from a distance and go. So they allowed us. We just went to the entrance of the ward, just saw it from a distance, from him a distance. And he was lying down on the bed, maybe sleeping, maybe a little drowsy, we don't know. And we came back.
Now, are you aware of the what his condition is right now? Or the since he is tested for positive for COVID, are the authorities sharing medical updates with you right now?
No, nothing. No information. We contacted the hospital, and the response from the hospital is as it is in the court, and we are waiting for the court directions or the state government direction. So as he is an under trial prisoner, we cannot give you the information. Directly, this is the response from the hospital to the family directly. And when some press people asked, they said it seems, media people asked, they said it seems that we will give the information to the jail authority. We cannot disclose to anyone. Today I called the jail authorities also. The jail authorities say that we don't have any information. And then I asked how to get the information, because from the jail, as he's under trial prisoner and he's in the custody of Taloja jail. So we have to ask them. So I asked them how to get information. Then he said, I will find out from the doctor jail doctor. If at all anything is there, I will communicate. This is what he said. This happened today morning. We don't have any information other than shifting him to Nanavati.